Good morning, everyone. We're continuing here in the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch, laws of activities that are prohibited on Shabbos, and we're speaking about the malach of kshira of time. Haderechu, it's common kishitzvichin liksha ezadavar b'shnei chutin or mishiches, when you have to tie something that has two threads or strings that are going to be joined together, oishem misabavin chut a mishicha achas, or when they pass a single thread or a string around some kind of an object, the koishin shnei katzav is yachak kederech achagura, and then they tie the two ends together, for like in the manner of a belt. Oisin shnei ksharim ze al gabi ze. That's like a double knot because it's one knot over the other. It's without the visual imagery over here, it's hard to understand. But when you're making a double knot, ki bekesh echad la yischazik, because the person knows that one knot is not going to hold it securely. The usher lasays kein b'Shabbos. You're not allowed to do this on Shabbos because that's making like a permanent knot over here, or we'll call it a professional knot. Shneik sharm zel gabi ze. When you have two knots, one over the other, afilu b'davish shadarka latir b'biyom. Even if you're going to remove it on that day, since that it's a good knot and it's a strong knot. That has the halachic status of being a professional knot. We don't really know what professional knots are today, and anything that's strong and good has the halachic status of professional. You can't do that. But tzvichin is all here, and you have to be careful. He says, "B'mitpacha shekorchin savi batzavar." A woman or a man is wearing a shawl or a scarf around their neck. Shalalaseis ba b'Shabbos shnei ksharim. Don't make a double knot on Shabbos. V'chein be'erev Shabbos, and even on Friday afternoon. You're getting ready to go to shul and you make a double knot so the scarf stays on very well. Don't do that either. Why? As we're going to learn later on, that being matir, which means untying a knot, which is a professional knot, also is a problem, and therefore you would not be able to undo this knot on Shabbos. Further, v'chein, Allah says, afilu kesher. If you want to make a single knot on one end of a thread or a string, or you take the two ends and you join them together, and you're trying to make them into one joint knot, because the reason is that that knot is going to remain securely and is treated like a professional knot. It could be that he's talking about something like a slip knot, if you know what that is. When it's a good solid knot, that is going to be an issue over here. Now what about when it comes to tying shoes or bows, these type of things? You have your two ends of the string, and you tie them a knot, and then you put a bow on top of that. So here the kitzur says it depends. If it's a kind of a knot with a bow that normally you untie during that in that same day, within 24 hours, mutter, then you're permitted to tie it. But if not, if it's something that you would leave there for a long time, even if you happen to intend to remove it within the day, but many other people would tie that knot and they would leave it there for longer than 24 hours, then you're not going to be allowed to do it. So this has to do, for example, tying shoes. Since most of the time, people, they tie a single knot and then they tie a bow, and it's meant to be undone on that day, therefore you could tie your shoes in the normal fashion. It's good to note though, over here, what about when it comes to taking out the trash on Shabbos, when a person has a trash bag and it has the strings at the end, the tie strings, how can you make a knot over there? If I make a knot with a bow in that particular case, that is a knot that is meant not to come out anymore, because you're never going to open up the trash again. So therefore, when you take the trash out of the can and you want to tie up the strings, you can only just pull it together once, so that there's not going to be a knot that is there. Avala says beza niva izal gabize. However, if you want to make one bow on top of the other, mutter, there's no knot beneath it. You're just making one bow on top of the other. Rafilo habi, even if any bows, one on the other. Rafilo imdaito shiyama ken yamin rabi, even if your intention is that it should remain like this for many days, since that's not a knot. Therefore, there's no issue over here of of transgressing the prohibition of kosher, of tying a knot when you're just making bows. Have a wonderful day.